Hello students, today we are going to understand one of the important articles from electrochemistry, and that is electrolysis of molten NaCl. Now let us understand first of all, what does it mean by the term electrolysis? It is the process which converts electrical energy into chemical energy. So let me write over here, in electrolysis we are going to make use of electrical energy and we are going to bring about conversion of electrical energy to chemical energy. All right, this process is widely used in electroplating, which deals with making simple thing, mainly metallic things, decorative. All right, so let us understand the basic principles by which the electrochemistry occurs or the electrolysis occurs. All right, now let us understand, for bringing of electrolysis of molten NaCl, I need to select my electrolyte, which is nothing but molten NaCl. As you know very well, when I take molten NaCl, I will have two types of free ions in it. Yes, the first is Na+, which is cation, electron deficient. The second is Cl-, which is anion, electron rich. Alright, now what we are going to do over here is, we are going to take a vessel in which the molten solution of electrolyte is taken, which is further dipped with some conducting rods, which are in general known as electrodes. So Na plus Cl minus is our electrolyte, to which we are going to dip some conducting material, which are called as electrodes. Remember one thing properly, whether they are anode or cathode, or which one will be anode, which one will be cathode, will be solely decided only upon connecting electric cell. Alright, so here we go with the diagram. Here we have taken electrolyte, which is nothing but molten NaCl. We have immersed some conducting rods, to which we have attached electric cell or a battery, which will provide me electric energy. Now what we are supposed to do, when we will start this electric cell, or when we will keep this circuit to the operating mode, we will find that this terminal is going to develop positive charge and this will develop negative charge. So here we will name our electrode as an anode, to which oxidation occurs, and we will also name this electrode as a cathode, to which reduction occurs. Now what will happen, the moment you start the electric setup, the moment you start electricity to flow across this particular circuit, the oppositely charged ions, or the charged ions in the solution, will simply come in action mode. Now what will be their action mode? It will be simply, positively charged ions will attract towards negative terminal and negatively charged ions will attract towards positive terminal. Okay, we are very clear on this. So now let's see what is going to happen. This chloride will try to attract toward anode for the sake of oxidation. As it is electron rich, it will lose electron and it will become discharged. The same, Na plus will try to attract towards cathode, which is negatively charged, and it will reduce so as to become discharged. And this particular migration or this particular movement is nothing but cell reactions, which is occurring inside the cell. So what kind of cell reaction occur inside the cell? As we have already studied, these are oxidation and reduction, which are all together called as redox. Remember always, oxidation occurs at first, followed by reduction. So firstly, oxidation, it will occur, and later it will occur the reduction. So oxidation will lose the electron. The electrons which is lost in the oxidation will be gained by the process of reduction. Let's see how it goes. So just look at this, Na plus and Cl minus. Tell me, which will undergo oxidation? It is but obvious, electron rich one. So how it will occur oxidation? Cl minus, it will move on giving you Cl. But as you know, chlorine is a gas, and all gases are said to exist in diatomic nature. Are we all clear on this? So as to give this reaction in diatomic mode, I will put Cl2 over here, I will put 2 Cl minus over here, and I will write liberation of 2 electron. Here is my oxidation reaction. Are you clear on this? Now, these 2 electrons will be absorbed in the process of reduction. So, how it will occur? Sodium plus. It is a monovalent ion. It will take 1 electron and it will give you Na. So, these are all about oxidation and reduction reactions occurring inside the cell. So, now, if I want to write the combined reaction which is known as Nate cell reaction, what I'll do? I'll just add both the reaction, I'll cancel the common factors, that is free electrons, and then I'll write the overall reaction. But you can simply see, here, there we find 2 electrons and we find 1 electron. So, as to make this number of free electrons equal, I'll multiply second reaction by 2. So, I'll put 2 over here, this will become 2, this will become 2. Now, this free electrons on opposite side will cancel with each other and it will give me 2 Na plus, plus it will give me 2 Cl minus. So, here 2 Na plus ions combined with 2 Cl minus ion, it will give me 2 Na metal, that is atom, and it will give me liberation of Cl2. So, this is what all about cell reaction. This is very important when you study concept of electrolysis, because these reactions are informing you what products are going to form in the end. So, what is the outcome of this process? Very simple. At anode, Cl2 gas is going to be liberated. This is very poisonous but useful gas in making some agricultural products like pesticides and fungicides. This product is also used as a reagent in many reactions. It is a kind of poisonous pale green colored gas. Alright. Secondly, what else is going to be formed? So, here at cathode, silvery white colored sodium metal is going to be deposited. Alright. So, you can simply understand, we have taken NaCl as our starting material, which was named as electrolyte. We provided electricity for bringing certain chemical change, and what kind of chemical changes we have got about? So, we have converted NaCl into pure Cl and pure sodium, which has different properties than that of the compound. So, this is nothing but chemical change. So, this is what all about electrolysis of molten NaCl. Thank you so much.